You can say that how successfully someone has treated somebody. Surgery here does not mean operation. Here the word surgery means the place where someone is treated. It can be a clinic, it can be a hospital, right? So in this chapter we're going to read a trump of surgery. See, in this gray box they have given the brief of the story, and the brief is: Tricky, a small dog, is pampered and overfed by his rich mistress. The protagonist of the story is Tricky. That means the main character around whom the whole story is revolving is Tricky here in the story. The story is about this dog who is pampered and overfed, always given extra food to eat, always being taken care of everything by his rich mistress, because the owner of the dog is a rich lady and she loves the dog a lot. He falls seriously ill and his mistress consults a veterinary surgeon. And when this dog falls ill, the lady, the mistress, she consulted a veterinary doctor. What is veterinary doctor? The doctors who treats the animals are called veterinary doctor. She consults a veterinary doctor. And now the chapter is that, does he perform an operation? Does the dog recover? Was the doctor able to fully recover the dog or not? This is what we're going to learn into the story, A Trump of Surgery. Now you can say that few questions are given into the beginning. Read and find out. That means after reading the story, a part of the story, you will be able to answer these questions. That, why is Mrs. Pemphrey worried about Tricky? Now this is, Mrs. Pemphrey is the name of the mistress. Mrs. Pemphrey is that rich mistress, the owner of the dog. What does she do to help him? Is she wise in this? Who does I refers to in the story? Now you see that the story begins with I. And this I in the story is the narrator. He is the doctor. The name of the doctor is Mr. Harriot. You will learn it into the story. But I will tell you that Mr. Harriot, the doctor, who's the narrating the story, is I here. I was really worried about Tricky this time. I had pulled my car when I saw him in the street with his mistress, and I was shocked at his appearance. He says, the doctor is saying that one day he was passing by and he saw that the Tricky was going for a walk with the mistress, Mrs. Pemphrey. And he says, I pulled my car. He stopped his car when he saw the Tricky on the road with the mistress. Because the narrator says that I was shocked at his appearance. Why? Because he was shocked when he looked at the Tricky. Because there was something surprising into the appearance of Tricky. What is it? He had become hugely fat, like a blotted sausage with a leg at each corner. So the narrator tells us that because the Tricky is so fatty and he has grown up so fatty that he looked like a sausage. He looked like, a big and huge box of something with the four legs. His eyes bloodshot and Rame started straight ahead and his tongue lolled from his jaws. Because his eyes were looking red and his tongue was falling down with the jaws, and he was feeling little listless and dull. Mrs. Pemphrey hastened to explain. Mrs. Pemphrey quickly started explaining to the doctor. He was so listless, Mr. Harriot. He seems to have no energy. And she's telling him that, Mr. Harriot, I'm really worried about my dog. It seems that he does not have energy. I thought he must be suffering from malnutrition. And you know, though he's growing fat, though he's building up so much, but still, what does she think? She thinks that that dog was suffering through the malnutrition. What is malnutrition? Malnutrition is when you are not able to get a balanced diet or the diet which is required. Though we will come to know in the story that he was overfed. So I've been giving him some little extra between meals to build him up. Some malt and cod liver oil, a bowl of Horlicks at night to make him sleep. Nothing much more. And what has she explained? She explained that because I felt my dog is getting weak and I started giving him something extra in between the meals. That means after the breakfast and before the lunch also she was giving him something. After the lunch and before the dinner also she was giving him something to eat. That may be a bowl of Horlicks, some cod oil, cod liver oil, right? Some malt. And this how she thinks that she was helping the dog to become stronger. And did you cut down on the sweet things as I told you? Now, Mr. Harriot, the doctor is asking this. That did you cut down on the sweet things? Have you started giving less sweet things to the dog? As I told you. Oh, I did for a bit, but he seems to be so weak, I had to relent. And she says that I did for a bit, that I tried it for some time only, but then I switched back and I again started giving him. He does love cream cakes and chocolates, so I can't bear to refuse him. I looked down again at the little dog. That was the trouble. Tricky's only fault was greed. He had never been known to refuse food. He would tackle a meal at any hour of the day or night. And I wondered about all the things Mrs. Pemphrey hadn't mentioned. And now the doctor could actually come up to the real reason. He could understand that what is the basic reason that why the dog has become so listless, why he was looking as if he does not have energy, because she was giving him extra meal every time. She was giving him lots of chocolates to eat, cakes to eat, sweet things to eat, though the doctor has already denied for those things for the dog. And what was the problem of Tricky? Tricky's only problem was that he loved these things. He could not refuse to eat. He's a greedy dog. You know, Tricky has a greed. He has a hunger of eating. Any time of the day you offer him anything and he would not say no. Yani, that means that though his stomach is filled, though he has already eaten something, but if something else is, some extra thing is offered to the Tricky, so Tricky was always ready to eat. And then I wondered about all the things Mrs. Pemphrey hadn't mentioned. And again, I his here, doctor only. Again, the doctor says that I wondered and I was thinking that, oh, Mrs. Pemphrey is not telling me which she is giving him. All that she is making him to eat. And that is why I can think that Tricky has grown up so fatty. Now, are you giving him plenty of exercise? Then the doctor asked that, fine, if you are giving him a lot of food, are you giving him a lot of exercise also? Well, he has his little walks with me, as you can see. And what he was having? Just some walk with the Mrs. Pemphrey, correct. But Hodgkin the gardener. She has a gardener who has been down with lumbago. What is lumbago? Lumbago is called backache. Lower back pain is called lumbago. So she said that he's suffering from lumbago. So there has been no ring throwing lately. And maybe that the gardener was throwing rings, was playing, was making him to do some exercise. But he was also unable to do those things with him during some last days. And that is why he was feeling dull and listless. See the dog. Isn't it his petty? I tried to sound severe. Now I really mean this. And he tried to sound severe. He tried to sound little strict. Right? Now I really mean this. If you don't cut down food right down and give him more exercise, he is going to be really, he's going to be really ill. Okay. So what has the doctor instructed? The doctor has suggested her that if she will not going to cut down with the food and will not give him exercise, then he will become more ill. You must harden your heart and keep him on a very strict diet. And also suggested that she need to harden her heart and the dog need to be kept onto the strict diet. Mrs. Pemfrey wrung her hands. Oh, I will, Mr. Harriot. I am sure you are right. But it is so difficult, so very difficult. And now Mrs. Pemfrey was still thinking that will I be able to do this or not? Will I be able to cut down with the diet of the dog or not? And she was worried that how will she make her heart so strong that she would refuse him to eat. She set off head down along the road as if determined to put the new regime into practice immediately. And it seemed that she was taking it serious and was thinking that now I have to somehow manage and instruct my dog and keep him on the strict diet. Okay, children, read the chapter till here, till whatever the amount of the chapter I have explained you. And then rest we'll continue and we'll look forward to it. Thank you.